in my hometown. Lakeshore Drive and Road is called, and it'll take you up or down. From rats on up to bridges, 15 minutes you can fly. Pretty blue lights along the way, help you ride on by. Pretty blue lights shining with a heavenly grace, help you ride on by. Like it anywhere I found, running south on Lakeshore Drive, getting into town. Just slipping on by on LSD, fighting that trouble bound.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Chicago. We're at the Quincy L station, and we are going to board a train to Merchandise Mart. Though the train that's on the platform right now isn't the right one. And you can tell just from my talking. A few minutes later, the Purple Line train arrives at the state at Quincy. We're gonna get on it and head over to Merchandise Mart. From there, we eventually would go into a hotel for our stay.
Doors closing.
Merchandise Mart. The same place, that the L blue Richard Kimball's cover
is next.
In The Fugitive.
Doors open on the right at Washington and Wells. Transfer to Metro Trains and City Hall at Washington and Wells.
What?
This is Washington and Wells. Transfer to Metro Trains and City Hall at Washington and Wells.
Quincy, we started at Quincy.
This is the Purple Line Express. Doors closing. Merchandise Mart is next. In the direction of travel, doors open on the right at Merchandise Mart. Transfer to Brown Line Trains at Merchandise Mart.
This is it, Dad.
No, it wasn't.
Or maybe we're stopped at a light. We're probably stopped at a light.
Your attention, please. We are standing momentarily waiting for signal clearance. We expect to be moving shortly.
Well, that answered that question. figured there was something up. It's probably a maintenance platform. Richard Kimball was trying to talk to his lawyer.
This is Merchandise Mart.
He said he
transferred to Brown Line Trains at Merchandise Mart.
He said he was in St. Louis,
this is Purple Line Express.
But a train going over was announcing that it was coming into Merchandise Mart. And got it.
The next day, we began walking towards Chicago's Millennium Station. Unfortunately, though, we cannot go anywhere in Chicago without getting shot at least once. And the footage you're looking at right now is footage I took where we weren't getting shot at. Welcome to America. Soon enough, we got to Millennium Station, and we're going to board a Metro Electric District train. The station is also a terminus for the South Shore Line commuter rail line. It used to be an interurban, but just weeks before this trip, the South Shore Line became not an interurban anymore. Soon enough, though, we departed from Millennium Street Station, and we're going to go down to 55th, 56th, and 57th Street Stations to go and visit the Museum of Science and Industry.
55th, 56th, and 57th Street, and yes, that is the name of the station.
Thank you.
Oh shoot, sorry.
Museum campus 11th Street.
approaching 18th Street, Flagstaff. Now approaching 27th Street, Flagstaff.
Thank you.
27th Street, Kenwood, left off. Are you sure? Because it looks like we're stuck at a light. I think it's the next one, Dad. The next one is our stop, Dad. Cars were actually built up by the same company.
I don't know.
Which train is this? University Park? University Park?
We got off our stop and headed for the museum. And at the museum, we saw the iconic Burlington Zephyr train set that was used in the famous Dawn to Dusk run that was set out by the CB&Q. Also at the museum was a display of U-boat U-505, which was captured by the Americans. And it had all sorts of information relating to the submarines and how the Americans captured it.
That was easy.
I also typed in a message that was slightly inappropriate so that the Enigma thingy could encode it. Also in the museum was a few displays of farming and a few pieces of equipment that was made by John Deere. Also here was a Boeing 727 from United Airlines, and the one thing that I came here for, trains. This here is New York Central 999, known best for a run where it allegedly hit over 100 miles per hour. This is also one of only three New York Central steam locomotives that have been preserved. All the rest were scrapped because of both New York Central's financial situations and because of Alfred E. Perlman.
Oh, oh, thanks, Steven! Good work! I know it did!
Inside of the locomotive is also a display of how this run came to be, and there was also a voice, like a mock-up of the engineer who actually ran the locomotive. Though, he kinda looks like as if he's staring into your soul, kinda.
Mileposts using handheld stopwatches, just as in a track meet. Al, the fireman, fed coal to the firebox with strength and skill, and I pushed the throttle full out, and we roared through Batavia in a bellow of black smoke and a cloud of dust. A crowd of people who had come to watch us were thrilled to see us whirl through in the fastest train ever. Back in the coaches, one of our railroad men shouted, 32! 32 seconds exactly! A 32-second mile. And that calculates to 112 and a half miles per hour. An amazing new speed record. Some people questioned our exact speed on this record day. Mostly ruffians from the Pennsylvania Railroad. I believe that the 112 and a half mile record was correct, but the skepticism still exists among rail fans even today.
And here is how I first knew of this museum, the Great Train Layout. Years ago, I saw this program from TM Books and Videos that was called The Great Train Story, and it showed of this layout right here. And while I can't show some footage from the actual show because of copyright, I will briefly explain what I saw in that show and what's different now. Most of the rest of the actual layout and creativity and whatnot is still the same, but a couple of the trains have changed. Mainly the BNSF trains, as there's now H3, as that video that I saw years back had mainly H2 locomotives and also a couple of Santa Fe units in BN2. There's also the fact that in the actual program that I saw, there were two Amtrak trains that kind of represented the Empire Builder, but now there's only one Amtrak train. The first Amtrak train actually had a Genesis pairing, while the second one had F-40 PHs, and also a couple of material handling cars. The video also showed Metropolitan Rail and a display of the CTAL, as well as the what was at the time the interurban South Shore line. There are also a few displays of like some of the stations and some fictional locations, as well as some mountains. And there's also the stations of King Street Station and Chicago Union Station. There are also a few, nowadays there are actually a few Union Pacific trains, as well as the typical BNSF trains, which is what are more commonly seen on the Northern Transcontinental line in real life. Also in the Seattle mock-up is a mock-up of what appears to be the Alaskan Way Viaduct. In real life though, the viaduct has since been demolished in 2019 and is being replaced by a tunnel, to my knowledge anyways. Yeah.
That thing right there, that's a replica of the double stacked highway in Seattle, but an earthquake in 2001 ultimately told the guys in Seattle, we have to tear this thing down before it kills a lot of people.
And so they did?
Yeah.
There's also a tiny mock-up of King Street Station in Seattle, and of a port in Seattle.
Yeah, that's Seattle.
Though in real life, that's the King port Street in Station. Seattle is probably way bigger.
And that's a port in.
So this likens back to an old time when trains used to exist and be used for shipping?
No, this harkens back from yesterday to today, where trains still used for shipping freight and all that.
Nice. Did you just use the word harken? Nice.
Yeah, I did use harken. Yeah. You know, in the thing that I watched, there were two Amtrak trains. One with an F-40 just like that, and another with the Genesis.
Wait, look at that. Look at that Jurassic.
Huh?
Look at that bridge.
Oh, that thing. I also saw that. Yeah, there's a UP train.
I feel like they're on that under that.
Yes, art.
They don't have trestle on there.
What? Yeah, I see that.
They don't have trestle on there.
No. Maybe it's because they think kids have seen it in stereotypical Western movie things. Oh, would you look at that? That one of the flaps on those things moved.
Really? Oh yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
Aviation geeks, if that's not the flaps, please don't endlessly go into a mental breakdown and tell me in the comments. Just calmly tell me if I'm correct or if I'm not correct. You don't need to go batshit crazy. There was also a camera recording one of the model trains from the head end, though I wasn't sure which train had the camera.
Okay, that's... maybe it definitely ain't the thing.
There was also what appeared to have been a mock-up of the original rocket locomotive. And I actually went inside the Boeing 727. Planes with three engines like this, like the 727, DC-10, L-1011, etc., aren't common these days anymore. There was also a huge Lego display that was at the museum at the time, and since I like Legos, I decided why not? Because who doesn't like Legos? Passing over the bridge right there is a good line, a fine line, a hard line, and a bread line. It's called the South Shore Line, and it shares some of the Metro Electric District's tracks. I took some video of a few southbounds while we waited for a northbound train to arrive. Because this piece of track is owned by Metra and it's so essentially a local agency. Essentially means that Metra could add as many trains as it would like onto these tracks without having to deal with freight railroads. It also allows for Nick TD, who owns the South Shore Line, to also use the tracks into Millennium Station. I think so, anyways.
Why are there so many trains heading south today?
I think it's to the south is the new north. Hey, second me to answer.
You don't want to fall down there. Especially not if a train were coming. You gotta be kidding me. The thing wasn't recording when I...
Last time you got on this side.
Yeah. Coming into the station is said good line, fine line, hard line, and bread line that I saw a train of earlier. At the time of recording, though, the train only went as far as either Hammond or Gary, because past that, they were double tracking the line into Michigan City at the time of recording.
McCormick place.
Sears Millennium?
Yeah, where is this Millennium?
Thank you. system exiting Inner Rail's final stop all the passengers. Millennium Med.
My name's next.
Stop there called Harrison? Oh.
Later that day, we went along the Chicago L to a Giordano's to get some pizza.
Right.
That's the photo of the pizza that we got. Man, if only Mom came with us. Then going back, we sorta kinda got on the wrong train and went one stop off of where we were supposed to go. But at least this gave me an opportunity to film some more. That there is Ogleville Station. It used to be the Chicago and Northwestern's terminal for its passenger trains, but nowadays only Metra uses that terminal. But who knows? Maybe there will be some more railroads that use Ogleville in the future.
This is Clark Atlanta. Transfer to green, orange, brown, and blue line trains, City Hall, and the Thompson Center at Clark and Lake. This is a pink line train to 54th and Cermak.
No, it's the next one.
Okay. Doors closing. State and Lake is next. Doors open on the right at State and Lake. Transfer to Red Line trains at State and Lake. This is State and Lake. Transfer to Red Line trains at State and Lake.
Here, Dad.
This is a pink line train to 54th and Cermak.
The next day, we went with a friend of Dad's, and she showed us a place of hers, and conveniently, that place of hers had a view of some train tracks, so I took some video.
Did they tear something down to build that, or was it?
It was nothing.
No.
So this is, behind here is this gigantic mid-rise building.
Harrison, there's one going across the bridge.
Yeah, I see that.
Gotcha.
And it's the merchandise mart, and it's owned by the Kennedys. Mm. And then that monstrosity over there.
And that is a Metra train that goes along one of the commuter rail lines that was once owned by the Milwaukee Road.
This is great, Harrison. See, you know, someday, Harrison, you could have a job in a place like this where you be around trains all the time.
Trains on the west side.
Do you know about the event when Rolling Stones and James Brown performed together? So, everything that you know about, well, a lot of what you know about, singer for the Rolling Stones?
Jagger.
Didn't exist before this event, because he watched James Brown do this thing. They followed James Brown, and so he felt like he had to do.
And so we decided to go down to those tracks. After a couple of minutes of waiting, we started to hear a bell, And I seriously thought that it was coming from one of the lines into Ogleville until... And then out of the tunnel came one of Amtrak's Hiawatha service trains. The Hiawatha service was originally started by the Milwaukee Roads back in the 1930s, and now the Amtrak carries on this train today. Amtrak does want to expand the Hiawatha to 10 round trips per day, but unfortunately Glenview is being a thorn in their side to even expand service, unless the people in Council of Glenview are bribed or something.
Mission accomplished, Dad.
After we went back into our hotel, we then went back out to ride the Red Line.
This plane is
next. Doors open on the right and north in Clybourne. Your attention, please. Please follow public health guidelines during the COVID-19 pandemic. Protect our staff and other riders by wearing a face covering at all times while on CTA service. Is Fullerton. Transfer to purple and brown line trains at Fullerton. This is a red line train to Howard.
We went on the red line train as far as Belmont. We thought that the L train fight between Richard Kimball and Sykes took place at Belmont Station, but in reality it took place at either Clark and Lake or Stade and Lake. Clark and Lake was named Balbo Station.
Natural park space. That was
This is Belmont. Transfer to purple and brown line trains at Belmont. This is a red line train to Powell.
Yep. Us here. At this point, though, my phone was kind of running a bit low on battery and space, so I skipped over a bit, and now we're on the blue line.
Standing vessel, please do not leave against the doors.
Yeah.
We got off at Damon before heading back to our hotel for the night.
With an E, not an O. Like my bro. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Doors closing.
Hang on, Dad.
The next day, we would go on two more CTAL lines before we went to Chicago's Union Station to take the California Zephyr back home to Denver. The first one is the CTA Orange line. It would go all the way to Midway, but we didn't have time to go all the way to Midway.
Do.
Doors closing. Roosevelt is next. Doors open on the left. And Roosevelt. Transfer to red and green line trains. And Roosevelt. Your safety is important. If you observe unattended packages, vandalism, or suspicious activity, inform CTA personnel immediately.
Orange line.
doors closing. Harold Washington Library, State and Van Buren is next. Doors open on the right at Harold Washington Library, State and Van Buren. Transfers red, blue, and brown line trains at Harold Washington Library, State and Van Buren.
Late. We'll get off at the lake, at one of the lake stops on the loop.
This is Harold Washington Library, State and Van Buren. Transfer to red, blue, and brown line trains at Harold Washington Library, State and Van Buren. This is an orange line train to Midway. Is LaSalle and Van Buren. Transfer to Metro trains at LaSalle and Van Buren.
Yeah.
This is an orange line train to Midway. Doors closing. Quincy is next. Doors open on the right at Quincy. Transfer to Metro and Amtrak trains at Quincy. This is Quincy. Transfer to Metra and Amtrak trains at Quincy. This is an Orange Line train to Midway.
Yep.
Iowa.
Huh?
Is that the Iowa?
Yeah. Yes. Goes to Milwaukee right as of now, but
doors closing.
But Amtrak wants to expand the Hiawatha to St. Paul and Minneapolis, and maybe even Green Bay
and
Madison.
Wells is next. Doors open on the right at Washington and Wells. Transfer to Pink Line and Metro trains at Washington and Wells.
I'd imagine that if there was an Amtrak service to Green Bay, then if there was a home game at home, Packers game at Green Bay, the trains in would be packed. Probably.
This is Washington and Wells. Transfer to Pink Line and Metro trains at Washington and Wells. This is an Orange Line train to Midway. Doors closing. Doors closing. Clark and Lake is next. Doors open on the right at Clark and Lake. Transfer to green, blue, and brown line trains at Clark and Lake. Clark and Lake. Transfer to green, blue, and brown line trains at Clark and Lake. This is an Orange Line train to Midway. Doors closing.
Next stop.
Doors closing. State and Lake is next. Doors open on the right at State and Lake. Transfer to Red Line trains at State and Lake. State and Lake. Transfer to Red Line trains at State and Lake. This is an orange line train to Midway.
Well,
that was fun.
Doors closing. Doors closing.
Finally, we would get on a Brown Line train and head towards Union Station after we went to the hotel we stayed at and packed our bags.
Right, Dad, here we go.
Is next. Doors open on the right at Quincy. Transfer to Metra and Amtrak trains at Quincy. This is a Brown Line train to Kimball.
Correct. Here we go.
After getting off at Quincy, we would soon head to Union Station, and then get on the California Zephyr to head home. But that will be the next video. Because for now, this video is pretty long, and I don't think any of the users that have attention spans of 2-year-olds are even paying attention at this point. Even so, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Have a good day.